Hi, I'm Sebastian from ECS, and today I'm going to show you how to set up your DejaVu QT4 device. First, we'll start off by making sure that the terminal's date and time is correctly configured. When you first power on your machine, it may auto-default to this home screen. If so, go ahead and press the settings option. From here, we'll press the three bars located in the top right-hand corner. Then we're going to scroll down until we see the date and time option, which is right here. You'll first want to deselect these two radio buttons to make sure that you're in the correct time zone. We're in Los Angeles, so we'll set it to Los Angeles. We'll then make sure we reselect these radio buttons, which automatically configure the date and time based on your time zone. Then you can just hit the circle button at the bottom, go back into Aura, and you're ready to resume transactions. Next, we'll make sure that the terminal is connected to the internet. To do so, we'll press the circle button located on the bottom of your device. From here, we'll press the settings tile. Once you're in the settings tile, you can click on the WLAN icon. It'll automatically bring you into a list of your networks. Feel free to select the network of your choice. It'll then prompt you to enter your password. And once the password is entered, you can hit the connect option right there in the bottom right corner. If you successfully enter your password, it'll automatically connect and it'll say connected. Once you're done, hit the circle button at the bottom, go back into Aura, and you're ready to resume processing. Next, we'll go over how to run a sale on the terminal. To start, we'll press the credit option located on the home screen. From here, we'll press the sale option. You'll then be prompted to enter an amount. Once entered, hit the green OK. The next screen will bring you to tap, insert, swipe, or enter your card number. For us, we'll go ahead and use our card, and the card reader is actually located on the side of the device. Remove your card when prompted to do so. After the approval message appears, if your file is configured to include a signature, you'll sign afterwards, hit the OK, and a receipt will print out. You'll then have the option to print out a customer copy if you'd like. If you want to save paper, you can hit no. You'll then go back to your home screen, and you're ready to resume processing. Next, we'll go over how to void out a transaction. To start, we'll press the star icon located in the bottom corner of your screen. From here, we'll press the void transaction option. Anytime we're prompted for a manager password, it'll be 1234, followed by the green OK button. This next screen, you'll have a variety of options to choose from. The easiest way to void out a transaction of your choice is to hit View All. You can then use the previous and next options to navigate through the transactions that you've run. Once you have the transaction selected, go ahead and hit OK on the void out prompt. One more time with the manager password. And then a confirmation of the void will then follow. A receipt will print out, and you'll have the option to print out a customer copy. If you'd like to save paper, you may hit no. You'll then be brought back to your home screen, and you're ready to resume processing. Next, we'll go over how to reprint a receipt. To start, we'll press the star icon located on the bottom right corner of your screen. From here, we'll click on the reprint receipt option. Anytime you're prompted for a manager password, it'll be 1234, followed by the green OK. You can then choose either last transaction, by transaction number, or by card number. Typically, if you're reprinting a receipt, it's because you've run out of paper or the last transaction didn't print out properly. So we'll click on last, and then you can choose your receipt type. Click on merchant copy, it'll print out the merchant copy. You can then do the same steps to reprint the customer copy. From here, you can press the back arrow to get back to the home screen, and you're ready to resume processing. Next, we'll go over how to settle the batch on the device. To start, we'll press the star icon located on the bottom right corner of your screen. From here, we'll press the settle daily batch option at the top. Manager password prompts will always be 1234 followed by the green OK. You'll get a confirmation of the batch settling, and a receipt will print out afterwards. Once the receipt has printed out, it will attempt to upload the transactions to the Denovo portal, and you'll get that confirmation afterwards. At this time, the device will also look for any applicable updates. If there's no updates required, it'll tell you as such and then bring you back to the home screen. From here, you can resume processing as normal. So that's how you set up your DejaVu QD4 device. If you have any other questions or want to view some of our other guides, be sure to visit us on the web at ecspayments.com.